Polyphonic Spree.
Thank you.
Simonon of the Polyphonic Spree, a band clearly not from London but from America. Now we welcome the man that did this picture and a man that was also in The Clash, Paul Simonon. Welcome to the program, Paul. Now, I'm very pleased you managed to come in today. A lot of people will know that you worked with The Clash, but a lot of people won't know is that you started off as an artist, and that's how
as a painter.
You've always been a painter, and that's how you started. But how did you get diverted into being in a band in the first place?
Well, I got disillusioned with art college because I went there to do life drawing. And unfortunately, they're more interested in American abstractism, which is fine, but wasn't what my calling was. So I lost track of what I wanted to do and ended up sort of in the group initially. And then after about 10, 12 years of being in a rock and roll band, decided to, I suppose, to say, not make tea for the BBC, but to get another job, which was to go back to painting again.
And the paintings are fantastic. We'll come on to those in a moment, but let's just remind ourselves of those heady days in The Clash. I think we've got a bit of footage of you all here. Let's just have a look. Should I come? If you say that you are mine, I'll be here till the day I die. Come on, let me know. Should I stay or should I come? It's always tease, tease, tease. You're happy when I'm on my knees. One day is fine, the next is black. So if you want me off your back, decided to put all that behind you and go into paint and take re-establish your painting credentials. But you were what I would describe a very London group, weren't you, from London?
Well, essentially, and I suppose that's sort of something that's not left us. And I suppose if you're looking for an influence, it's that they always say it's on your doorstep. And I think The Clash, along with many groups like The Kinks, The Stones, refer to their doorstep. In the same way as with painting, for me, it's sort of it's continual vision.
And that's what inspires you most of all. What tell me, these latest paintings, which are amazing, have been very well received. I mean, you know, it's been a huge sort of success.
I must admit, it's the weather actually, because I used to think that to be a painter, you had to be in a room, cut away from the rest of the world, what they usually call a garret. But that vision sort of put me off, and that's why as an edgy teenager I got into music, really. But I sort of discovered after the whole Clash thing finished, I went outside to start painting, and it was sort of pretty inspiring being out there in all the weather, because it was changeable. And at times it was rough, as a rough and ready audience, possibly like the Glasgow ilk. I don't know, I managed to sort of get off on that, and it, you know.
I believe as well, didn't you go to the top of Geoffrey Archer's flat to take one of your views
on
the river?
Yeah, but Geoffrey didn't realise I was there.
Well, you sneaked in with a canvas big, unnoticed.
I could have left my canvas there, and what I could have taken out was quite a financial kudos, really. But actually, I went there just to paint. And the unfortunate thing is that I was having a chat with a friend, I said, Yeah, Geoffrey Archer's views are fantastic. And I sort of thought, actually, no, that's not what I meant. Actually, the view of the Thames is fantastic.
Yeah. And there they are. Well, it's very nice of you to come in, and I think that it's tremendous that I mean, our music, you know, can you see, are there any parallels between a career in music and a career in painting for you?
Well, only in so far as that if you have a vision in your mind, you just got to go for it and just keep going at it. Mm. And that's the only parallel. And fortunately, I knew how to paint before I played bass. So I'm still here to paint.
There you are. There you go. Well, thank you very much indeed. Paul Simonon, thank you.
Marvellous.
Now, from one musical style, from one painterly style to another, let's welcome back the wonderful Yusun Jools.